各位同学，大家好，我是国立暨南大学国际长颜玉芳，欢迎各位同学回到摩克斯印尼文的部分。今天我们要来学的是一般生活的绘画，总共会有两个课程，希望同学要跟着我们一起学习。
Halo semuanya, kembali lagi bersama saya Lia Asuti. Welcome back with me, Lia Asuti. Saya akan menjelaskan tentang percakapan. Yeay! So, what is percakapan? Percakapan is conversation. Percakapan is shema, percakapan is huihua. So, this is not your first time, right? To have percakapan. This is not your first time to have percakapan, right? So, now I would like to focus for guide you the first part of percakapan. So, later I would like to explain to you the second part of percakapan. But now we will focus for the first part of percakapan first. What is the first part of agenda? Agenda hari ini pertama or yang kesatu is the basic things that you should know for conversation. So, what I will talk to you for the first one is all because a lot of foreigners that have a wrong interpretation about some of the term in Indonesian when they are doing conversation. So, there is some of foreigner or there is some of learner that learning Indonesian that have the something mistakes, that have a mistake with how to conversation with Indonesia language. And then the second one is the Indonesian praises. So, for today's agenda, I will focus for the first one, which is the basic things that you should know before conversation. So, the first one that I would like to guide you is all about alphabet. So, we have learned about the alphabet, right? Alphabet. The basic things that you should know for conversation, the first one is alphabet. You have learned about the alphabet at the first part of pengaturan grammatical. So, alphabet in Indonesia is using like in English, which is use Latin. That using for A, B, C, D until Z. Do you still remember how to rememorize A until Z in alphabet? Do you still remember it? Yes, we have ever sing a song, right? Do you want to sing a song and to memorize the alphabet for Indonesian term? The alphabet for Bahasa? Okay, you can sing a song with me. Now, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Yay, you did it! So, the next one is the things that you should know. The first one is alphabet, and then the second one is the use of alphabet. So, the use of alphabet, that is differentiate between two. The first one is formal, and the second one is informal. Okay? What kind of formal is that? So, usually, in Indonesian, we are using all the vocabulary is using for formal and informal. For formal, we are using usually at writing. So, what kind of writing? It can be a lot. For example, the paper, the journal, the newspaper, the article, and etc. that using the formal writing. Okay? So, after that, we will have the use of alphabet that using for informal. So informal is using for the speaking or conversation or for daily speaking. For example, informal, right? Speaking and daily speaking. Before I teach you about the conversation, so this one alphabet is the things that you have now before you are doing conversation, okay? So the next one is the use of alphabet to say no. The use of no is using for formal and informal. The using of no in Indonesia for formal way is tidak. For informal, we are usually at Indonesian people using enggak mau or tidak mau. So for chatting or even for chatting for informal way, we are using enggak. Enggak means no. Enggak means tidak. You have learned, right, about the grammatical arrangement about tidak. You have learned tidak at the grammatical arrangement or pengaturan grammatical at the second part, right? So after that, after the use of alphabet, how to say no at formal and informal? No, we will learn about the things that you have know that the using of vocabulary. So lucky you, if you want to learn bahasa, vocabulary in Indonesia not using gender. What is that means? So several of vocabulary in another language is have make a differentiation between a things for woman and things for man. Or I can say, vocabulary in Indonesia is not divided into gender. Vocabulary in Indonesian term, not using a gender differentiation. For example, we have no masculine vocabulary and no feminine vocabulary. Okay, so after that, after I talk about the alphabet, the vocabulary that you have to know that at learning bahasa, now the next one is grammatical. So you have learned about grammatical arrangement, right? You have learned about pengaturan grammatical. So pengaturan grammatical in Indonesia, we just have verb for predicate. What is that means? In Indonesia, grammatical that using verb is not using conjugation. What is conjugation? Do you know what is conjugation? Conjugation is all about the differentiation between the verb that use for past, for present, and for future. For example, this one. Grammatical of the using of the verb or the using of kata kerja. So there will have no differentiation between past, present, and future. Makan. What is makan? Makan is eat. Okay? Makan, shishima, makan, shichir. Okay, so the first one, if I ask you, the past one is makan, the present one is makan, the future one is makan. If I ask you, right, how about the term in English? So I would like to give the example, the term of past of makan or eat in English. The past one is I ate noodles, or in Indonesia, saya makan mie, right? Can you see the differentiation? I ate noodles. So do you know that eat, the first verb of eat is eat, the second verb is ate, And then the third one, the third verb is eaten, right? So in Indonesia, we just say, saya makan mie. Okay? So in present, now I would like to say to you how to say makan or eat at present. So in present, I will say, I eat noodle, right? So what I'm doing, that what I'm doing is for compare between present at English and present in Indonesia. In Indonesia, we just say, saya makan mie. It is so easy, right? So the past and the present is really same. Just say, saya makan mie. How about in the future? In the future, we just say in English is what? I will eat noodles. How about if I say in Indonesia? If I say in Indonesia, saya akan makan mie. So the verb is same from the past, present, and the future. What makes it different is just the time. You just add the time. For example, if the past, saya makan mie kemarin, or I ate noodles yesterday. If present, I just say, I'm eating noodles now. So, in Indonesia, I just say, saya makan mie sekarang. Okay, how about the future? The future is, I will eat noodles tomorrow. So I just say saya akan makan mie besok. So the using of kata kerja grammatical in Indonesia, we have no conjugation. Okay? Do you get what I mean? So in conversation, we just use the same verb, okay? Because you have learned the verb, right? You have learned the verb at my another video about kata kerja. Okay, so the next one is the structure or struktur. So the structure of Indonesian language is divided into two. The first one is the simple sentence. The second one is the complete sentence. For the first one is simple sentence. It contains of subject, kata kerja, and pelengkap. Actually, you have learned about my another video, right? And then the second one is complete sentence. Complete sentence, you have learned about the another video about the arrangement of the grammatical or pengaturan grammatical. That is one of the example of complete sentence. Complete sentence is about subject, kata kerja, objek, keterangan. So simple sentence, the first one, the structure of simple sentence, example, seems like saya makan buah, subject, kata kerja, pelengkap. So it's just subject, the verb, and the complement. Saya makan buah. Just have the subject, the verb, and then the object or complement, which is buah or the fruit, right? So that is so simple and it is so easy. So how about the structure example of the complete sentence? This one. So if I told you the example of complete sentence, what does it mean? So what does it mean? Complete sentence, it means that you really make a sentence become clear, become understand, become really clear. Because if I ask you about saya makan buah, if I ask you buah apa or what kind of fruit or where are you, what time, and etc., right? So the complete sentence is this one. Saya makan buah di ruang keluarga saat pagi hari jam 8.30 pakai garpu. So, do you know what that means? In English, I would like to say to you that saya makan buah di ruang keluarga saat pagi hari jam 8.30 pakai garpu. Do you still remember how to say jam or waktu in Indonesia? I ever told you, right? How to say waktu in Indonesia, we just say the nomor or the number. 8.30. You can also watch my video about waktu. Okay? So, I ask you, how I translate it into English? So, it's become, I eat for it at my family room in the morning at 8.30 o'clock using fork. So, I have told you at grammatical arrangement, at pengaturan grammatical part 2, right? Okay? So, now, I would like to say to you, saya, what is saya? Saya is the subject. Kata kerja, in this sentence, makan. Saya makan. Makan itself is kata kerja or the verb. Buah. Buah is object. Di ruang keluarga. It means kata keterangan tempat. So, S-P-O-K. Do you still remember that predicate is one of kata kerja? Predicate is kata kerja, so you don't need to confuse, okay? Predicate or kata kerja. Makan, so it's become S-P-O-K. So, I have explained to you that keterangan is divided into several things. It can be keterangan tempat, keterangan waktu, keterangan item, and etc. So, the first one is, I have told you, saya makan buah di ruang keluarga. It means SPOK. Okay? So, if I told you, saya makan buah di ruang keluarga saat pagi hari jam 8.30. It means I add keterangan waktu. Okay? Do you get what I mean? So, after that, I am using pakai garpu. So, it means I use keterangan item. Pakai is use, right? So, can I add more verb? Can I add more kata kerja? Yes, of course. It can. So, I can use pakai kata kerja whether in this sentence have makan. So, it means that pakai garpu. It means that kata kerja that using for garpu or the fork. So, it can be like that. So, the differentiation between complete sentence and simple sentence just have subject, verb or predicate, and then complement or the object. And then the structure of the example complete sentence is using contents of SPOK, subject, subject, predicate, object, and keterangan. Okay? You get what I mean? So, that's one is the things that you should know before you are doing conversation. Okay? So, after you are learning about the structure, now you have to learn about possessive. What is possessive? Possessive is kepunyaan. So, possessive in Indonesia, it is using object plus subject or object first or object plus subject. So, what is that means? Now, I will give you the example. This one, possessive that using in Indonesia, we are using object, subject. Mobil saya. It means my car. So, my It is using for subject or saya, right, in English. And then car is using for object, which is mobil. So in Indonesia, we combine it into mobil saya. So in Indonesia, we just make it into vice versa, okay? It's become mobil saya. Do you get what I mean? So object plus subject. It means mobil saya. For example, this one. It's become? Yes, it's become baju saya. Okay? Yay, you did it! So it's easy, right? So you have to remember, before you are doing conversation, you have to remember this all kind of the things that you have to remember before you are doing conversation. Okay? So the next one is using the adjective. So you have learned about adjective, right? Or kata sifat. So the using of adjective or kata sifat is used with the term of noun plus adjective. For example, new car or mobil baru, right? So I just vice versa between new into the last one and then car into the first one. So mobil baru. Do you get what I mean? Yay, you did a great job. Okay, so it's quite hard, right? But you have to know before you are doing conversation. The Indonesian princess we will to learn the second one. Yay! So the second one we will learn about the Indonesian phrases, okay? What is phrases? Phrases in Indonesia is frasa. So frasa. What is frasa? Frasa is the Indonesian phrases or phrases. So in Indonesian, frasa or frasa Indonesia have fourth one or have a fourth big part. The first one is greetings. The second one is farewell expression. The third one is holiday and wishes. The fourth one is solving misunderstanding. So what is that means? Now I will focus for the first one, which is greetings. Now I would like to remind you that greetings is I have explained to you by the first video, which is Sapaan dan Perkenalan, or greetings and introduction. Okay, so you can follow me how to say greetings in Indonesia, and you can follow me if you want to become act like a native speaker as in Indonesian as me. So you can follow another video, which is this one. Okay, Sapaan dan Perkenalan. So because I have guide you to learn about greetings, now I would like to go to the next topics, which is farewell expression. So farewell expression, it seems like expression, your expressi, expressi kamu, your expression. So I have so many examples of the greetings, and then also I have so many examples of farewell expression. So now this one is one of the examples of the farewell expression. This one is semoga hari ini menyenangkan. What is that means? I hope today you will be happy. Semoga hari Anda menyenangkan. Semoga hari Anda menyenangkan. Semoga hari Anda menyenangkan. And then you will say, ya, terima kasih. Okay? Do you get what I mean? So, the next one of farewell expression is mimpi indah. What is mimpi indah? Mimpi indah seems like have a nice dreams in English. So now you can follow me how to spell mimpi indah. Mimpi indah. Mimpi indah. So mimpi indah. You can tell to your boyfriend or girlfriend seems like selamat malam, mimpi indah. Or your best friend or even your family, you can say selamat malam, mimpi indah mama. or selamat malam, mimpi indah ayah. Okay, do you get what I mean? So this one is selamat malam and mimpi indah. The next one is sampai nanti. Okay, so what is sampai nanti? Sampai nanti seems like see you later. Okay, so now you can say to another person that if you meet in Indonesia and then after that you just say sampai nanti. What is see you later? So see you later, it means that we never know which time that we will meet with them, right? Which time that we will meet to he or she. So it means that we just say sampai nanti. So how about if we want to meet for tomorrow? What is tomorrow in Indonesia? Yes, tomorrow in Indonesia is besok. So you have learned about the day, right? In the time or waktu. Okay, so sampai besok. What is sampai besok? Sampai besok is see you tomorrow. Okay, it's easy, right? So the first one is sampai nanti. The second one is sampai besok. And the next one is sampai jumpa. Okay, sampai jumpa. Sampai jumpa seems like goodbye. Goodbye. So goodbye in Indonesia seems like sampai jumpa. Okay, so you can understand, right? So sampai is not always see you in Indonesia. So sampai jumpa or goodbye. So after farewell expression, we learn about holidays and wishes. Yay! So for the phrase or frasa, you have learned about the greetings at the first video that I have told you, and then I have guide you, right? Greetings and introduction, or sapaan and perkenalan at the first video. Second one that you have learned about farewell expression. And then now the third one is all about holidays and wishes, okay? So now I would like to explain to you about several of the phrase or frasa at holidays and wishes. What is that means? It means that seems like you are wishes or hoping the good one, the positive things. For example, the first example is semoga beruntung, wish you luck. Okay, wish you luck. What is that means? Semoga beruntung. Semoga beruntung. Beruntung. Semoga beruntung. Okay, so that's one. If you use semoga beruntung, it seems like you will go to somewhere and then after that someone just told you semoga beruntung in that place. So it means that some people wishes you that you got a luck or lucky that the place that you will go. Okay, so the next one is selamat ulang tahun. So, selamat ulang tahun seems like ni de sheng re kuai le. Or, for example, happy birthday. Okay, so selamat ulang tahun is happy birthday, right? So, that seems like the expression for the wishes and holidays, right? And then the next one is selamat tahun baru. Or happy new year, or 新年快乐. Okay, selamat tahun baru. Selamat tahun baru. So you have learned, right? Tahun is nian or year, baru is new or 新. So selamat tahun baru. The next one is, the example of holidays and wishes is selamat Natal. Selamat Natal. What is selamat Natal? Selamat Natal is Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Selamat Natal. Okay? That is The example, another example of holidays and wishes of Selamat Natal. So, the next one is Selamat Hari Raya Idul Fitri. So, in Indonesia, we Selamat Natal for the Christian. Okay? So, the next one is Selamat Hari Raya Idul Fitri. What is that means? Selamat Hari Raya Idul Fitri is Happy Eid Mubarak. What is that means? Selamat Hari Raya Idul Fitri is for Muslim or Islam. Okay? So, the next one of holidays and wishes is Selamat or Congratulations. So, the next one is Selamat Menikmati. Okay? What is Selamat Menikmati? Selamat Menikmati seems like enjoy. Enjoy. So, in Indonesia, we just say Selamat Menikmati. Okay? So, the next one is solving misunderstanding. What this means? Solving misunderstanding seems like you are doing something wrong and then you just say sorry and etc. So, no, I would like to say to you that how to make a phrase or frasa that one of the example is solving misunderstanding. So, you have learned about the first one is greetings. The second one is farewell expression. The third one is holidays and wishes. And then the fourth one is solving misunderstanding. So, what is that means? Solving misunderstanding, the first example is permisi. What is permisi? Permisi is seems like excuse me. Permisi shi shema, permisi shi buhaise, haise qingwen. Okay, you can follow me. Permisi, permisi. Okay, it's so understandable, right? And it is so easy. So the next one is solving misunderstanding. The next one is maaf. Maaf is sorry. Maaf shi tuebuchi or buhaise. So maaf itself, it can be maaf sekali. Maaf sekali in Jongwon can be duebuchi. Or just maaf can be seems like maaf. Maaf for the small things. And then maaf sekali is for the big things. Or the big mistake. So, maaf. Maaf is sorry. Or maaf shi buhaise. Maaf sekali shi tuebuchi. Okay? So, the next one of solving misunderstanding is apa ini? For example, if someone just give you a things. For example, you give me a things and then I just accept it and then I just ask you apa ini? Apa ini? It means that, what is this? What is this? Okay? So, if you give me some things and then after that, I just ask you, apa ini? Apa ini? Okay? Do you get what I mean? So, that is the example, another example of solving misunderstanding. And then, now, for the next one of solving misunderstanding, it seems like, jangan khawatir. In my example, if you are so worried so much, and then after that, somebody just told you, jangan khawatir. It means that, don't worry. Okay? So, what is jangan khawatir? Jangan khawatir is, don't worry. Okay? Do you get what I mean? So, it's easy, right? So, jangan khawatir. Jangan khawatir. It means, don't worry. Okay, so the next one, apakah ini salah? What kind of solving misunderstanding is that? For example, you are doing something and then you just don't know is it wrong or is it false or is it correct or is it true? Okay, you just asking to others and then, apakah ini salah? Okay, and others will just say, yes, ini salah. Or, others just say, ya, ini salah. atau ya, ini salah, atau or no, it is true, or tidak, ini benar. Okay, you got what I mean? So, what is apakah ini salah in English? Apakah ini salah? Seems like, is it wrong? Is it false? Okay, do you got what I mean? So, that is the expression of solving misunderstanding. How you solve when you got misunderstanding in yourself or in your environment. So, it means, apakah ini salah? Okay, so the next one, apakah ini benar? So, I have told you that apakah ini salah? And then, the opposite of salah is benar. So, if I ask you, apakah ini salah? That is the English one, is it wrong? Is it false? In English of apakah ini benar, it seems like apakah ini benar. In English is it true or is it right? Okay, or is it correct? Okay, so that one is apakah ini benar for solving misunderstanding. So, that's all from me. Sampai jumpa. Thank you so much for all of your kindness to see and to watch this video until the end. And then, sampai jumpa. See you on the second part of conversation or percakapan. Bye-bye!